By next year, Uganda's population is estimated to hit a 52 million population figure, with a housing deficit clocking 4 million housing units. According to the executive director of the National Housing, Engineer Kenneth Kaijuka, constructing houses for rent or sell will continue being big business for many years to come. While many investors are already tapping into this opportunity, there's still a lot of virgin market which Kaijuka wants Ugandans living in the diaspora to tap into through investing in the real estate business.
As of now, if it is a residential subsector, you must be focusing on the rental market. And the rental market is slow at returns, so that means you'll return your money over a longer period of time. Of course, outright purchase is also there, but those are few. When you look at that, you know, population trajectory, it is expected to be moved from 45 million today to 100 million Ugandans. That is also another indicator that will attract investment in that sector, whether it is accommodation, the residential, or even commercial, where people work from, or even institutional, like schools, student accommodation. So, an industry is where...
He gave assurance to the players in the real estate industry that they are in the final stages of approving the real estate bill into a law, adding that once this law comes into existence, they will be able to effectively govern the establishment and operations of the business.
Then you want to make sure that the ground is as appropriate to enable the business to run. One of them is the real estate law. Yes, hitherto we didn't have an appropriate real estate law that brings together all the players in the business. Those in land, those in the construction, the developers, those in the supply chain of materials, and those who are middlemen, the brokers, and the marketeers, and ultimately looking at the market, the consumer. So this law has been crafted, and I'm proud that National Housing has been a key player in making sure that this law is in place. But as we speak, it is before Parliament, and it is championed by the Minister of Lands, Housing and Urban Development with all the real estate developers. We hope and pray that by June this year, this law should be in place to enable and facilitate investment and business in real estate.
In order to bring down the costs, he expressed a need for the housing stakeholders to collaborate. For instance, if one has land, they can partner with someone who has adequate finances to put up buildings. These remarks have been made today during the soft launch of the Concept Kickstarter Conference 2024 in Kampala, which attracted Ugandans living in the diaspora, stakeholders in the real estate industry, and officials in the Ministry of Lands, Housing and National Development. The Executive Director of Concept Real Estate, Brian Kayongo, explained that the objective of the gathering was to provide insights into the investment opportunities in the real estate business.
Advance each other. We are here to increase innovation in Africa. We are here to... they talked about real estate is not only the asset you are here, like this hotel. It's all about infrastructure. It's all about technology. It's all about partnership. It's all about financing. That is what real estate is. And we are here to continue with the Kickstarter program to expand with you guys and be part of this, and to tell nations that we need one by one unite together and build something and kickstart your life. And that's the future of Africa and the whole world at large.
He highlighted that the Kickstarter conference, which is scheduled to take place in March this year in Boston, United States, will offer unique opportunities for real estate investors, especially those interested in investing in Uganda. Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.